At the outset of this lesson, I talked a little bit about multistates and how and why they're used. For this part of the exercise, we'll be utilizing multistates to provide quick insight into the performance of each of our wells and well pads. Let's start with the well-focused asset comparison table. Right-click on the table and select Add Multistate. A multistate configuration pane will open on the right-hand side of the window where we can select different columns to add multistating to. Select Production Rate and check the box that reads Enable Multistate. We'll modify the state colors so that high values are shown in green and low values are shown in red, with a color gradient between them. Dark green at the top, then light green, then yellow, then orange, and finally red. You may have noticed that so far, we focused on both the state of North Dakota as a whole and the individual wells that it possessed, but we don't have any real information about the well pads within North Dakota that organize the individual wells. In this part of the exercise, we'll focus on those. To the left of the Assets pane, we have two additional items underneath the Assets button, Events and Graphics. Click on the Graphics button, which will replace the asset tree with PyVision's built-in graphic library. Scroll down until you find the Plant Facilities category and expand it. Continue to scroll down until you find this oil well graphic, and click and drag it onto the display next to Dickinson. Right-click on the oil well graphic and select Configure Multistate. Return to the asset tree and drill down into the North Dakota element and highlight Dickinson. Find the average production rate attribute and click and drag it under the multistate attribute header on the multistate configuration pane. We'll then repeat our work earlier with the asset comparison table's multistate colors to reflect high production rates in green, low production rates in red. To represent the rest of the well pads, we'll copy the multistated oil well graphic we created for Dickinson and paste it for each one of the remaining cities. Select the graphic in the display and either click the copy button in the toolbar or use the Ctrl-C keyboard shortcut to copy it. Then paste it 4 times using the paste button in the toolbar or the Ctrl-V keyboard shortcut. Click and drag the copies to each one of the remaining locations. If we look at the multistate settings for each of the remaining wells, we can see that they're all following the production rate at the Dickinson well pad. We need to update this so that each oil well graphic reflects that well pad's respective production rate. To do so, we'll start with the Crosby well pad. Right-click on the oil well graphic and select Configure Multistate. Then, click on the Crosby element in the asset tree and find the average production rate attribute. Click and drag the attribute over to the multistate configuration pane and drop it under the multistate attribute header to replace the Dickinson production rate. We need to be careful to replace the attribute here, as opposed to clicking the trash can icon and removing the Dickinson attribute first, because doing so would require us to set our state colors all over again. We'll then repeat this same process for the three remaining wells, Kenmare, Stanley, and Williston.